Rev up your engines.
Martins Collins says, Scotty, I'm thinking about buying a Mark II Golf as my first car. What do you think about them? Okay, I'm not a fan of Volkswagen because they tend to fall apart, the ones they sell over here, after so many years, and it costs so much money to make people all get rid of it. Every customer I've had in the last 15 years in the United States that bought a Volkswagen never bought another one. But I know they're very popular in Europe. I just came back from England. And parts are cheaper there. A lot of times people buy them in Europe and they're relatively happy with them. So if you live in Europe and there's mechanics around that work on them and do good work, might not be a bad idea. But in the United States, dumb idea, because they just fall apart. The only customers I ever had lately that would buy something like that is they buy it used dirt cheap. They get a car that had 80,000 miles on for like $1,500. Still don't have much invested. If it lasts a few years, hey, they make out like gangbusters. But buying a new one is really stupid because they resale values, ooh, they plummet. Don't ever buy a new Volkswagen because when it's time to sell it, you're going to lose most of your money. Marcus Martin says, hey, Scotty, I got a 99 Ford Ranger and the AC only comes out of the defroster vents. I'm wondering what could be the problem. Okay, realize that all modern cars, the default is defrost. And the reason it's that way is if you have a problem in your venting system and things start to break, it will automatically go to the default position, which is the defrost, because they want you to be safe. They don't want the windows fogging up if it's raining outside. So if the system's breaking down, it's better to have it blowing on a windshield so you can see where you're going. Maybe you're not going to be so comfortable. You're not going to crash into somebody because the window's fogged up. Even though it's an older vehicle, it's still all computer controlled. So it's probably you got a problem in the actuator door inside the dash. And the only way you can really analyze this stuff, you got to find a guy like me, and we hook up our high-level scan tool, and we can do bidirectional testing. We can test different actuators and see what's broken, and generally on that, we got to take the whole dash apart. Now, I mean, you can check electrical connections, see if any vacuum lines came off, but normally on those, it's a problem in the actuators. And you can't guess because it's such a complicated system. You got to have a guy with a dealer-level scan tool and analyze it, doing testing back and forth, unfortunately. Natalie Chen says, Scotty, I'm about to buy a Dodge Caliber. What's your general opinion about the car? I don't have that much money to spend on a car. Well, if you don't buy that car. Those things are endless money pits as they age. You know, if you don't have much money to spend on a car, hey, look for like an old Toyota Corolla or an old Camry. I've seen them go 400,000 or 500,000 miles. I've had people buy used Camrys and Corollas with like 180,000, 200,000 miles on them. They didn't pay all that much. And sometimes they were still driving them 4 or 5 years later with another 100,000 miles. That'd be the better thing for you to do. Those Dodges, they fall apart as they age. And if you don't have much money to spend, you do not want to buy a used Dodge. It would be a big mistake. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.